Up off the rubber to reset. Oh, that ball got him pretty good out there on the mound. Safe at first, and now after the play, we'll check on the right-hander status. White Sox going with a new arm, Jose Alvarez.
Now pitching for the White Sox. Number 48.
Man at first with one gone, Jose Ramirez.
Alvarez
digs in for the Guardians.
Batting third, the third baseman, Jose.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kicks and fires. Altuve leads off first with one away. That one in for a strike, 2-2.
That was the pitch to hit. Four-seam fastball instead of that sinker ball that makes you hit it on the ground. He missed a good one.
Altuve runs. Next offering is fouled back. Alvarez picks to first. Altuve back safely. Next offering upstairs. The pitch. Runner goes again. Fought off foul. The kick, the 3-2. Runner goes again. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Runner on the move again. Out to short, Anderson. Gathers and throws to first. There to beat him by an eyelash. Josh Bell at the plate now.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
And first offering is fouled off. And the pitch. In the air, fairly deep to right field. And that is that. Bottom of the first, here's the shortstop at the plate, Tim Anderson.
Leading off for the White Sox.
The wind to the pitch.
The shortstop, Tim Anderson.
That one missed. The 1-0. This ball's chopped on the ground. On the run, sends it over to first. He is safe. And now it's Luis Robert. Good contact guy, good defender. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Nobody out, runner at first. There's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
The pitch. On the ground, the third might be two. One at second, and they get him easily at first. It's a double play. Yasmani Grandal up to hit.
The catcher, Yasmani Grandal.
Hard hit left side, and that one finds its way through, and that extends the inning.
Batting four.
Two outs, runner at first. And now the first baseman, Pete Alonso.
Alonso.
Hit hard, that gets through.
All That's back-to-back singles for him. Just one of those seen eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Here's Yelich at the dish. The lefty to 1-0. Now 1-1.
That pitch started in and ended up on the outside edge. Just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
Grandal, the lead runner out at second. Alonso at first, two out of the inning. The next pitch misses, and the count's even at two.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
And a pitch. Got it. Inning over. Here on the south side, second inning set to go. And now the DH, Daniel Vogelback.
Daniel Vogel, your attention, please. He's hitting for Cleveland. Number seven, Brendan Rodgers.
Alvarez back to work. Swung on, belted. That one back there. And that ball is gone. Brendan Rodgers blasts one out. The Guardians strike first. It's 1-0. Francisco Lindor digs in for the Guardians.
Batting six.
And Cleveland on top once in.
Francisco Lindor.
In the air out towards right center. Margot sizes this one up, grabs it on the run. And there's one down. Now it's Hunter Renfro. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
And the first offering is not close. And now the lefty. And that one fouled off. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss. And that one almost got him. Next pitch has popped up. Gonzalez settles under this one. Brings it in, and there's two away.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Your attention.
Two outs, base is empty. Jason Castro will hit next.
Mike Zunino.
That one's in there, 0-1. Here comes a pinch. Chopped left side. Collected by Torres. Third out, and that ends the frame. Yo, black gun with a style Kobe. Running through all your OGs. They crying over boo-boos. I'm dodging the law, yo. Smooth criminal step. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field. Bottom half of inning number two. Now it's the second baseman, Gleyber Torres.
The second baseman. Labor.
That's a strike. Strike one. Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
Next offering is down low. Now 1-2. The wide to kick the pitch. That smash towards center and makes the grab. And there's one down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Check swing. Now we'll look down to first. No swing. The pitch. That one ripped, but foul. The pitch. Late that time, and it's strike two. 1-2 to Margot. Next offering is outside. Pulls it down, and there's two gone. And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana.
But designated hitter.
Bounce to third. Tosses to first, and the inning is over. Welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Now batting Tim LoCastro.
The guardian, the center fielder, number 33, Tim LoCastro.
And a pitch. On the ground to the left, Anderson gloves it, and a quick out number one. So the Guardians lineup turns over. Andrew Benintendi steps up. He's 0 for 1.
Benintendi.
Benintendi, the former first-round pick, Golden Spikes Award winner. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. Left-hand hitter waits. Way high there, and the count is 1-1. And he deals. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That's got a chance. Didn't quite have enough. Two outs, base is empty. Jose Altuve, the next to hit. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Out to short, Anderson collects. That's the third out.
I finally made up my mind to take a better stand. Concentrating my balance, give life a...
Back here on the south side, bottom of the inning. And now, Romy Gonzalez.
For the White Sox, the third baseman, Romy Gonzalez.
Zimmerman back to work. High fly ball out of the left center field. Benintendi on the move, and there's one down. Back to the top of the lineup. Now it's the shortstop, seven. Tim Anderson. Shortstop. Reached on an infield single his first
Anderson.
Time. Fouled off. He was late. And a base hit on the line. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. You see a ball now come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the exit velocity? This time,
off-balance feed, there's one. And it's a double play to end the inning. And welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. And now it's switch hitting third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
The third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
And here it comes. And first offering is fouled off. At the belt and fires. Pitch is in there. No balls, two strikes.
Well, I think that pitch surprised all of us. Right down the middle, doesn't get a swing. Not very often you see a hitter lay off a cookie like that.
stays alive.
Man, he'd like to have that pitch back.
Line drive, base hit. Now he'll turn for second. The throw in. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap. And when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent swing.
Matt Foster on a pitch out of the pen here. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Tosses to first. That's the first out in the top of the fourth. Now it's Brendan Rodgers.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Brendan Rodgers.
Base knock center field. In comes the runner from third, and they lead by two.
Picks himself up an RBI. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Here's Francisco Lindor. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes the grab after a long run. And there are two down. Man at first, Hunter Renfro at the plate. First time up was a pop out. First offering misses the mark. Smash to the left side. Toss to Alonso, and Renfro is retired. And that is the third out of the inning. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go, bottom four. Now it's the White Sox catcher, Yasmani Grandal.
The catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Guardians. Number 78, Jordan.
The pitch.
Holloway.
Down and in, moved his feet. Righty delivers. Nope. And that's outside.
Two balls, no strike.
And another ball. A wind in the pitch. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
High fastball, even a little above the zone, but such a good job of staying tall on the backside. Get that barrel there to meet it just in time. I'll tell you what, it's not easy to do. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball there. And the right-hander deals. Rolled to short. Possible two ball. Over to Altuve. On to first. Double play. Now it's Christian Yelich. Struck out swinging his first time.
Yelich.
That hits the dirt, and that's ball one. Two down, nobody on. And it's one and one.
Wow, no fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move to the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just kind of have to tip your cap on that pitch.
Base hit, and that keeps the inning alive. Here is the young phenom, Gleyber Torres. He's 0-for-1. Swings through that one. 0-1. Looking at Torres, have to say he's one of the most impressive young players I've seen in recent years.
Well, no question about it. His future is very bright. The city, the organization, both are excited about him. He has a lot to look forward to.
Swing and a miss. One and two. Yelich off of first with two away. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. When you think about it, he may be in the league for the next 10 or 15 years. That one off the bad part of the bat, just a lazy fly ball. And Gleyber Torres retired. And that is that. Trust me when I tell you no exceptions. Here on the south side, here's Mike Zunino.
Leading off for the Guardian, the catcher, Mike Zunino.
The right-hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. 0-2 now. Little chopper rolls foul. Right-handed reliever. Hammered down the line. And now maybe extra bases. Around first. Digging for two. And he's there with a leadoff double. Now here is Tim LoCastro. Bunt attempt popped up. Alonso racing over to make the catch to second, but way too late. Safe there.
Now back left fielder Andrew Benintendi.
In the air, out towards left center. Great effort as he's able to haul it in. Two down. Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve.
The second baseman, Jose Altuve.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runner at second, two down. And the righty deals. Slice down the right side. One and two now. Altuve waits. It's softly on the ground left side. Toss to Alonso. And that is that. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field, Manuel Margot up to the plate.
For the White Sox, the right fielder, Medwell.
The wind of the pitch.
Margot.
Off the mark there, and it's 1-0.
It's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike one. Next offering is foul back. And a swing and a miss. And there's one away. And next is the designated hitter, Carlos Santana. 0-for-1, he grounded out in his first at bat. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. LoCastro under it, puts it away for the out. Romy Gonzalez now digs in now. Flied out his first time.
Romy Gonzalez.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss as he was late that time. Going to count 1-2.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
And down on strikes. That's the inning. Back here on the south side, here's the third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
The third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
Here comes A.J. Minter to the mound, and he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 33, A.J. Minter.
The pitch. Up the middle, and that's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Here's Josh Bell. And that's in there for strike one. Kicks and fires. And a foul ball. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Next pitch, not close, up high. And now the lefty stays alive. Ramirez gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Next offering is fouled back. Lifted in the air, right center field. Margot should have this one. Drops into the glove. One down. Brendan Rodgers now at the plate.
The basket, number seven. Designated hitter, Brendan Rodgers.
And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Robert drifts towards it. Two away. And now it's Frankie Lindor.
Now batting, shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
Here's the pitch, runner on the goal. That's in for a strike. And safe. It's a stolen base. Two outs. And one in scoring position. Oh, and two as he waves at that one.
And he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Two outs.
Rarely will you see a pitcher just waste a pitch like that. The batter wasn't even tempted to swing. Every pitch needs to have a purpose so that it can set up a following pitch to help you get that out.
Next offering is fouled back. Kicks and deals. And a ball evens the count.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Two two. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Lindor retired. And that'll do it. Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth. Here's Tim Anderson.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
Out towards right center field. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's one away. Luis Robert now. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Check swing, went around, 0-2 now. And a pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Next offering is downstairs.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Next pitch inside, and it's 2-2. In the air, right field. Renfro going back. Back some more. He's got it. And there's two down. And now up to the plate, Yasmani Grandal.
Yasmani Grandal.
Rolled softly, but that goes foul. The 0-1. And there's a foul ball. And the pitch stays alive. Next offering is fouled back. And now the count is even. The pitch. And down on strikes he goes. Three up, three down, inning over. Back here at the ballpark, now it's Hunter Renfro.
Leading off the field, the right fielder is at play. Hunter Renfro.
Minter back to work. That's in for a strike. Here comes a pitch. That catches the corner. And a pitch. And fouled off.
Wow, he got away with a mistake right there.
And a foul ball. The pitch. On a line, base hit.
Really nice job, a two-strike hitting in that at-bat. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely.
Mike Zunino getting ready to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Minter, he's one of those guys who uses the cut fastball as his primary offering, and when it's on, it can induce a lot of weak contact. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
And the late movement on the cutter is really what makes it so effective, because as a hitter, you make a decision whether you're going to swing or take a pitch before it actually gets into the zone. So that late movement causes it to miss the barrel of the bat, sometimes miss the bat entirely.
At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. So digging in, Tim LoCastro.
Tim LoCastro.
On the ground, a second, might be two. There's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. Tell fans a little bit about the difference between a cutter and a slider.
Well, a cutter looks more like a fastball, but it has that late movement like a slider that's hard to pick up. Now, with the slider, it's a...
LoCastro on the run. Pitch misses. Tag. Save. Grandal's throw not in time. LoCastro stands at second with two gone. Swing and a miss. That's strike one. The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Well, anytime you launch one foul that has the distance, it's tough to reset for the rest of the at bat. He's going to have to do it here. You know, that changeup didn't fool him by much, but it did its job and had him out front.
Runner leads away at second. Broken bat, and it's popped up. Toss to Alonso, and that's the third out.
Yeah.
set for the last half of the seventh. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Sox, Pete Alonso.
For the White Sox, the first baseman, Pete Alonso. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now pitching for number 49, Eli.
The wind of the pitch.
Morgan.
There's the swing and a miss. Righty delivers. And ball one. That one is upstairs.
Now you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Got him. And that's the first out. And now it's Christian Yelich.
Number 22, Christian Yelich.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. Swing and a miss. Next pitch misses inside. Now one and two. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
The second baseman.
Here's Gleyber Torres.
Torres.
In there, and it's 0-1. The pitch. Swings over the top of that one.
More and more guys are looking to slug regardless of the count. In this situation, we'll keep a close eye on his approach.
Oh, and two now. Just missed.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone.
Got him looking. Down on strikes, and he knew it. Ready to begin the eighth. So in now for Cleveland, Jose Altuve.
The guardian, the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Keith Hembree. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Hembree.
The pitch. Slider misses outside. Right-handed reliever. Popped up. And they get Altuve for the out. And there's one down. And now, Jose Ramirez. For the fourth time tonight.
Jose Ramirez.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Yelich makes the grab. Two away down. Two outs, base is empty.
Now
and now the switch the hitting first baseman, Josh Bell.
Bell.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. And here it comes. Strike two. And a foul ball, he stays alive. To the right side. Gets it to first, and that will end the inning. Bottom of the eighth, here's Manuel Margot.
Leading up for the White Sox, the right fielder, Manuel Margot.
And the right hitter back to work. Just missed. Next offering is in for a strike. And he deals. This one popped up. And there's one down.
That hanging breaking ball looks so juicy to the hitter, and now nothing more frustrating when you miss that pitch and you pop out. He's going to have to think about that until his next at bat.
And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss, and it's nothing in two. Left-hand batter waits. Stays alive. The 0-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And the right-hander deals. And it's fouled away.
Just a little too quick on that front shoulder, front hip, front foot. Everything comes open. No way of making contact with that one.
The punch out there, two gone. Now down the third baseman, Romy Gonzalez. That one's in there, 0-1. And that's downed away. The 1-1. Back to the mound. And it finds its way through for a hit. So now back to the top of the order.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
So two down now. And here is Tim Anderson. First offering misses the mark. The tying run at the plate. He swings and fouls one off. Gonzalez off of first with two away. Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2.
Looking very settled on the mound here in the eighth. One more out. They'll probably hand it off to their closer for the ninth with at least a two-run lead.
Slice to right, and it's into the gap. So that's two straight two-out hits.
Just a huge at bat right there. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, it takes so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
0-1 down. Liner picked on the hop at first. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over.
Yes.
All set to start the ninth in this one. Now, Brendan Rodgers.
Leading off for the Guardians, the designated hitter, Brendan Rodgers.
Hembry back to work. And delivers outside. And the righty deals. In the air on the infield. Makes the catch. One away.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
The shortstop.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. To third. Lindor retired. Two outs, base is empty. And now the right fielder, Hunter Renfro. One for three. In there for strike one. That one to first. Alonso steps on the bag. That's out number three. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field. And now the catcher comes up to him. Yasmani Grandal.
The catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Your attention, please. Now pitching for Cleveland, number 30, David Robertson.
And the pitch. Swings and misses. And that is strike one. Robertson, he's known as a reliever that excels in really tough situations, those high leverage spots. It seems like he's at his best in these situations, and obviously the ability to get the strikeout factors in. Kicks and fires. Got him. And they get the leadoff man in the ninth. Here's Pete Alonso.
Yeah, there are certain guys that expect to come in and dominate, and they see the challenge, the battle, just a little bit differently. They trust their stuff, and they believe that their stuff is better than that guy standing in the batter's box, what his swing, what his ability is.
The 0-1.
Two pretty nasty sliders to get this hitter in an 0-2 count. You're up there at the plate, you got to look up in the zone and spit on anything that's down.
The punch out there, that's his second strikeout. Christian Yelich steps to the plate for the White Sox. The mental approach is a big factor too, isn't it?
Yeah, Boog, it is. And, you know, for each guy, it can be a little different. Some people consciously work on focusing, slowing things down, breathing techniques. And then there's some players that are just natural, and they just seem to be more composed and less excitable.
Just one strike away. And now 1-2. A lot of times with relievers, they just like to get amped up, and they're not really looking to try and slow it down, right? And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, a low-scoring ball game in this one. 2-0 game, few errors, pretty clean. That's kind of what you want to see in terms of defense and pitching. A couple of runs was all it took to get the W today.
2-0, your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shombe. We'll see you soon.
The final run score for our ball game tonight. First, for